Education Minister Tim Egger launched the £20 million drive to improve standards in inner-city schools by returning to traditional teaching of the 3 hours. In fact, the government's only putting up £12 million of the cash. Local authorities will have to find the rest. It means the inner London boroughs will have to compete against each other and city schools across the country for a possible share of the money. The scheme has been condemned by the Labour-controlled Association of London Authorities.
I think it's a derisory sum. It fits very ill alongside the fact that over 2 years, the government, through poll tax capping and other cuts, has reduced the budget of inner London education authorities by £150 million. This is £20 million, 3 years, across the whole of the country.
It's money that comes out of the total amount of money, 350 odd million, that is made available by government to LEAs. But we're using this money to gear ourselves specifically to helping underachieving children in inner city schools and to ensure that schools are properly supported by parents.
Pupils at this school in Islington achieve some of the best reading results in the capital, but its head has attacked the government proposals and claims schools across the region are suffering because of underfunding.
I consider that schools and educational authorities shouldn't have to compete for educational funding. It should be every school's right, particularly in this day and age, to have proper resourcing for education. It's every child's right, it's every parent's right. And at the moment, education is seriously underfunded.
The £12 million will be divided between 24 local authorities over 3 years. The scheme should start operating by next April. This is Jane Ball for Thames News.